Hello everyone, in this tutorial I will show you some basic shortcut keys and editing of your Python script in PyCharm IDE. When you write a code, it is a good practice that this is done in such a way that anybody that has access to your code can easily read and understand your code and its functionality. Hence, it is important that we go through some of the shortcut keys and editing tools that would enable you code in a better way. Shortcut keys allow you to be more efficient when writing, running, or debugging your script. And as a beginner, you don't need to memorize all the shortcut keys, but as you continue to use them on a daily basis, they gradually become part of you. Interestingly, PyCharm has provided us with a cheat sheet of different shortcut keys. And to access this document, all you need to do is to go to your menu bar, select the Help option in the menu bar, and in the Help drop-down menu, you just click on Key Map Reference. And once you do, you see this shortcut key cheat sheet here for you. So my advice would be you can print this cheat sheet and then gradually learn how to use each of the shortcut keys as you continue to write your code on a daily basis. PyCharm also gives you the option to configure your shortcut keys the way you want. All you need to do is to go to File and go to Setting, and then you see Key Maps. You could import your own type of shortcut keys that you want to use. I'm not going to discuss that in detail because I've done that in my previous video. So you can go to my YouTube channel and then you can watch this video on my PyCharm tutorial on Key Maps plugins, and then you will have more detail on how to configure the shortcut keys to what you want. So let's jump into the shortcut keys and the editing tool. So if you come to your editing menu here and you click on it, you see that you have been provided also some shortcut keys on how to use some of these your editing tools, like to cut, to copy, to duplicate line, to toggle case, to shrink selection, to extend. So we're going to be using some of the shortcut keys on this my Python script that I have written here. As well, you can also cross-check them in the cheat sheet that we downloaded initially. Yeah, so some simple things you could do, especially if you are using Windows. You could use Ctrl C to copy, like we saw in that editing menu. And then you can do Ctrl V to paste, Ctrl V again to paste. You could do Ctrl Z to undo, Ctrl Z, and then you undo the action you have carried out previously. And then you could also do, so let me repaste again now. And then you could also do Ctrl X, like we saw there, to cut, and then it's gone. And then you could also do Ctrl V to paste. Next thing you could do Ctrl F to find, let's say you want to find a particular variable, you could do Ctrl F, and then it gives you this option to key in the variable or a function that you want to search. So let's say I want to search for A. And wherever A appears, you see, it's going to highlight that A and all that. So let's close this. Let's say you want to select a particular line here or a particular word. You could select that word. And if you want to extend your selection, you could use Ctrl W and then you extend the selection. And if you want to shrink your selection, you still hold the same thing. And then you press with Shift to read, Shift, Control plus W, and then you're able to shrink your selection Another quick shortcut key we could do here, rather than do copy and paste, remember I did copy and then I paste, Ctrl V and all that, Ctrl Z. You could decide to use the duplicate line shortcut key. So all you need to do is to hold your Ctrl key and then you press D, so it will duplicate the line, Ctrl D, to as many numbers you want, rather than copying and pasting. Another thing we could do here is we could decide to use a shortcut key to locate any function or variable that we have used in our code. Let's assume that you have a huge code that you've written and you want to know where all your A appears as a variable in your code. So you could use Ctrl B. All you need to do is put your pointer to that variable or function that you want to identify in your code. And then you could select Ctrl B, and then it gives you a list of all the references to A that you have in your code. Same thing you could also do for a function, for a class. So let's look at another shortcut key to rename your variable or your function. Again, let's assume that you have a huge code that you've written and you have a particular variable or a particular function that you want to change all across the code. Rather than go start searching for wherever you have that variable and then to change it manually, you could use some shortcut key to do that. And that is what we call as refactoring. So let's say I want to change A probably to something else. Maybe I decided I want to change the name. So I could use a shortcut key to refactor that variable. So all you need to do is to hold down the shift key and then you press F6. It now gives you the option to change the name of that variable. So let's say we change this now to say Z. And once you're happy with it, it's going to change this again in the entire project file, or if you have a particular selection that you wanted to change it or wherever it appears, then you could make that selection. So for this case, we're interested in changing it in this project file. You click on refactor. Then you see everywhere we have A now has changed to Z. PyCharm also have these autofill options where it provides suggestions for you of possible errors in your code. So let's assume you have a particular error within the code as you've written it. PyCharm can automatically give you suggestion on what error that is there and how you could fix that error. So to toggle that on, you can use a shortcut key. Let's say you use a shortcut key Alt plus Enter. And then you see here it's telling me that a possible error here is formatting error. So I could reformat this code based on what it is currently. So to toggle that on, that option menu, you can select Alt plus Enter key. Next one, we could look at creating a breakpoint. So to create a breakpoint, you could also use a shortcut key by selecting, let's assume I want to create a breakpoint here, maybe for debugging. You could select the control and F8, it creates that breakpoint. So to run this file, we could either come here and then click on this icon to run, or we could use the shortcut key, which is Shift F10. So I will use Shift F10 to run this file. So I press Shift F10, and then the file has run successfully here. So here in this code, I have a prompt here to say, please enter your password, and if the password is correct, then you should grant access. So I'll just type in the password here. So the password here is PyCharm. So I'll just enter PyCharm and press enter, and you see the password is correct. You say access granted. Secondly, if you want to rerun, let's say I tried this and it didn't work. So to rerun your code, I could use Shift plus F9, and then I'm able to rerun this code again. So you see here it's asking me again to enter the password. So now I can enter my password, which is PyCharm. And if I'm happy with it, then yeah, it says access granted. So if you look at our code, our script is just everywhere. It's not too organized. So we could format this code using the shortcut key for formatting. And that shortcut key is Control Alt, and then you hold down the Shift key, and then you press your L alphabet on your keyboard. And then here you could decide to format the whole file, or if you're using version control, so you want to format only the text that you have made changes. So in this case, I want to format the whole file. So you could just leave this selection and then you can run the format. Then you see it would carefully reformat the program so it looks very neat. And that is it. To wrap up this tutorial, we've been able to look at some shortcut keys and your basic editing tools using shortcut keys. I hope you find this video useful. Please hit the like button and subscribe, and see you in the next one. Thank you for watching.